So it's time for a fun do-it-yourself project. And to do it today, I enlisted some help. We came out to Leawood. I'm hanging out with Audrey Kuether of Oh So Lovely Blog. And her daughter, Viv, is here. And my daughter, Ellison, is here. So first off, have you two ever worked together before?
No.
No? Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to make a fun project today that Audrey has on her blog. We are making fizzy bath bombs, or fizzy bath salts,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, fizzy bath salts. It's pretty much exactly like a bath bomb, but so much easier. And then you get the same results in the bathtub. So
this would be a great do-it-yourself project that we can do with our kids, right?
Absolutely. Viv helped me make all the ones you see here in front of us. So it was a really easy kid project.
Oh, so you're a pro at this already.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And we've tested them out, I will say, and they do work really well.
Okay. Well, what ingredients are we going to start off with?
Yeah, so we'll start with the dry ingredients. We'll do a cup of Epsom salt. You could really use any kind. I always kind of like lavender, just if it helps like you sleep at night.
Oh, yeah,
you
it's take a good scent to have, sure.
A cup of baking soda, which okay. You can get you any brand you want to use. And kind of the most special part is the citric acid, and you'll want to do a half cup of that, and that's what gives it that fizz in the water.
Okay.
So this will be the most important part, and this will be a half cup of that, and then a half cup of cornstarch. Any brand will work.
Mm-hmm.
And then we only have two dry ingredients. There's fractionated coconut oil. I didn't actually know this existed, but I found it on Amazon. So
fractionated.
Yeah, it's already melted
oil.
Down for you. You don't have to do any of the melting, and it stays melted. So I think that's the difference.
Can you melt coconut oil and then use that, or do you think you have to have it? This is fractionated.
I actually did when I made bath bombs before. I did. It was a lot of work, and it got really messy, and it didn't stay. It didn't stay as liquid as I would have liked. So I think this is the best thing to use.
This is the way
and
to
it's
go
really then. Affordable too.
Okay.
So. And then just whatever essential oil you like to use. You know, you want to do like 3 to 6 drops just to give it that nice scent.
Okay.
And that's it. And then you'll want to have any kind of jar. Really, I just scoured the house, found a couple mason jars, a couple little spice jars, you know, different little Tupperwares. So really just a container is all you need, and then give them just a bowl, whisk.
All right. So just some just easy ingredients to start out with.
Mm-hmm.
Just some containers to put it in and an easy bowl to mix it.
Exactly.
And I know you said earlier we have some Tupperware. But
this
is a kind of a cheap way to mix
it,
right?
For a while we were stirring in some of this different colorant, because I didn't mention we do have some soap colorant too, which this will just give you the color.
Okay.
It takes a while to stir it in with the whisk, so I kind of got lazy halfway through and found a hack that you can just dump it each color into the Tupperware separately and shake it.
Okay.
And then it mixes it all together really quickly.
Perfect.
So
we have a fun DIY project
with
a hack.
Yes, exactly.
Right. And we're back in Audrey's kitchen and we're getting ready to make. Why? Is this thing on? No. Okay. Well, we're back at Audrey's kitchen here. We're making a fun do-it-yourself project with our kids today. Again, we have Ellison and Viv here, and we are making fizzy bath salts.
Yes.
We've got all our ingredients out. It's time to start making it. I'm excited. Are you guys excited?
Yeah!
All right. How do we get started?
Okay.
What do we have?
First part's really easy. You're just going to start mixing in your dry ingredients.
Okay.
So I'm going to let Viv dump in 1 cup of baking soda. So dump that in the big bowl.
Okay.
So you're going to want to work out of 1 big bowl. Okay, now Ellie, you get to dump in 1 cup of Epsom salts. Okay.
Get it all in.
Perfect.
Dump it all in.
Awesome.
There you go.
And this is that half cup of citric acid that gives it that fizz. You want to dump that in, Viv?
All right.
Okay.
Careful.
Dump her in.
Careful.
Good. And then Ellie, you get to do the cornstarch. That's a half a cup of cornstarch. Yep. Got that? Just dump the whole thing. And you can use 2 hands if you want to.
There, why don't you bring it around this way? There you go.
Perfect.
Perfect.
Okay, so now we can all just take our whips. If you two want to do it, just stir everything gently together. So you're going to want to mix all the dry ingredients together, okay?
There you go.
Perfect. And I can help a little bit. See?
It already smells pretty good.
Yeah.
Is that citric acid
or
the citric?
The lavender.
Oh, that is the lavender.
Yes, that always helps kind of get it started, so it already smells good. And
okay.
So now that the dry ingredients are mixed together, now we're gonna just slowly stir in the wet ingredients. So I'm gonna have you two keep stirring while I put in the wet ingredients, okay?
Yay.
All right. You can make a little mess, that's fine.
Let's not get bath bomb stuff all over Audrey's kitchen, okay?
And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put in this 3 tablespoons of fractionated coconut oil.
Okay.
So we'll just do 1 tablespoon at a time and kind of just slowly put it in and kind of spread it over the whole bowl. And you two just keep stirring, okay? Gentle stirs, good job.
Now is this, have you guys used these bath salts here?
Yes.
And you guys really like them?
Yes, Viv used them first and then I used them that same night and I really like them. They leave your skin feeling super moisturized. Oh, that's okay, we'll shake it out. And it's perfect for these dry winter months, you know, when your skin's itchy and dry, so yeah. So
been running the heater all day,
and
it's just dry air in the house.
So you could use it every day, and it's it's wonderful. And it also the lavender helps you kind of sleep better at night.
Yeah.
So what you're gonna wanna do is kinda get all these clumps out. So until you, you can kinda just mix them down until you get some of these big clumps out. Viv, you wanna do a little bit?
Do you see how they're clumping in there? Can you try to get some of those bigger clumps out?
So this part takes a couple minutes, you know, just wanna kinda, it's just getting everything sorta wet. It's not ever gonna be goopy or anything like that. So, and then you can take your
favorite. Oh, you don't like the way that it smells? No.
I think she just breathed some in.
No.
So then you take your essential oil, and again, you can use any kind that you want, any brand that you want, any scent that you want.
Uh-huh.
And so you can do 3 to 6 drops. I kind of like to do a little bit more because I like to have that nice scent. So this is also lavender.
Okay.
So here you go, guys. And just a little bit comes out each time. Okay, so yeah, stir that in. Stirring it in. Yeah, good. You're breaking up all those clumps. Good.
It smells better.
It smells better now, yeah. You like lavender, don't
Ellie, you're making a mess here.
Yeah, this can be a little bit of a messy project, and that is okay. We've done all the mixing, right? Now, we don't want to put that in there with no color, right? You want to have some color in your bath salts?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the next step...
Is color!
Yes, so this is where these four smaller bowls kind of come into play.
Okay.
And then this soap colorant here, I bought like a 12-pack online, and they do have some scent, but they also are food coloring pretty much. And you could use different kinds if you'd like.
But this is soap colorant and not food coloring.
Yeah, and honestly, I think food coloring would work just fine. So there's tons of options online, and they're all really affordable. Just kind of evenly divide the mixture from the big bowl. We can just do a cup at a time into the smaller bowls.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be perfect. There's no real measuring that needs to happen. And you kind of just do it until the big bowl is empty. Now it's her
Good
turn.
Job. Let's get you some filled up here.
Yep.
Okay.
All right. You ready to mix?
Here, we're gonna dump that in there. Oops. Good job.
Okay, so you guys get to do two colors, or actually we can each do one if that works.
Okay.
So, what I have found, the lighter colors, you might want to put a couple extra drops in. The darker, like let's say the purple, and if you use a blue, you don't need as much. But really, I just add some, start stirring it in. If you feel like you need more, just add more.
What's a good amount to start with?
We start with about 6 drops.
Okay, so only count 6 drops.
So yeah, you can count 6 drops. You don't have to be perfect.
2, 3, 4. I think that's like... squirts there.
She did that too, Vivian, and they turned out great.
Okay.
There you go. About 12.
Oh, yeah.
There's no right or wrong way. And if you want to do the same with the purple,
here,
then
just do a few in there. And you can start on that one, I'll start on this
and
one.
And I'll do the green.
Just do like 3 or 4.
Comes out kind of fast, doesn't it?
That's plenty.
Okay.
Thank you. Good job.
So everyone's going to want to get your whisk again.
Get your whisk back. Do you want that one?
Here, we're going to each do one, okay? Okay, so now all you're doing is gently stirring. And you see how it's kind of bubbling?
Yeah.
That's that citric acid.
Is that the citric stuff?
Yeah, it's kind of going to work. Because anytime it hits a little bit of liquid, it kind of bubbles up a little bit.
It starts making that bubble.
Yeah, and that's
what
does in the bath water.
If I paid attention in chemistry class, I could have told you what type of reaction
it was. Right. Yeah, I didn't.
Girls study in school, okay?
Yeah, exactly. After you kind of mix it in initially, you guys can use one too. And we'll just do one color at a time.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, you do the pink first, okay? You want to dump the whole bowl into here? Okay, take that, perfect.
Can I shake it too?
Yeah, you can shake it, we'll both shake it. Just dump the whole bowl in, perfect. Okay, so then you just shake it hard. Hold the lid down while you shake it, okay? There you go. So you
want to
shake it
one?
For about 30 seconds or so, and then mom or dad can kind of shake at the end to kind of really get it mixed up.
All right, forward.
Perfect. Yeah. So this saves a lot of time. Before, I was stirring for at least a good 5 minutes for each color.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody has time for that. So you'll just take your spoon and you choose whichever color you want to layer in the bottom. So if you want to get that layered effect. So take whatever color you want and just kind of start spooning maybe 3 spoonfuls in. So once you're happy with that layer, then just go ahead and take out of another color. And I'm going to take some of your pink. How about that?
Okay.
Yep.
I'm going to try your yellow here.
Okay. Go ahead. That lid right on there. There you go.
Put it on top.
Yeah.
Put it on top. And get it tight.
Some of this yellow in yours, Viv. You need to help you fill it?
Let's see it. You know which one's yours and which one's mine?
I have a feeling both of them are going to be hers.
Yeah, they're both probably going to be hers.
Yeah, that's kind of what happens, right?
Mm-hmm.